Well, next to you, of course, Michael. Other than, yes, the weekend is coming up, and you're probably wondering which movie to go and see with your date. And well, we have the answer. It is the newly anticipated film, The Book Thief.
Mama, they're coming. They're checking basements.
If anyone saw him, they would take you away from me. And they cannot tell you what they will do to him.
Let's step into the Fox Light with Michael Tamaro. He has all the details.
Good morning.
Yeah, so how you like this?
I loved it. It's an old-fashioned period drama. So refreshing in the era of Bed, Grandpa, and other movies like that. You know, it's about a girl who has everything going against her in life, but finds hope and escape in the power of words, learning to read and write. It's directed by Brian Percival. It's based on a bestseller by Marcus Zucas. It's starring Jeffrey Rush, Emily Watson, and this newcomer, Sophia Nelisse, who plays a little girl who is, this girl has it all going for her. The movie's rich in themes, and we asked the cast when we sat down with them recently what they want audiences to take away.
You look, Germany has an amazing heritage of literature and music, great philosophers, etc. And this was a dark chapter where it was going completely off the rails and corrupting a huge percentage of the population. But if you look at the story, it's storytelling and literature and poetry and music that become the positive, generous,
the hope,
healing, the hopeful aspects of how people lead their lives.
You know, the movie wasn't supposed to open up until next year in January, but Fox is so optimistic about its chances that they moved up the domestic release to now, so it has a chance at a potential Oscar.
Yeah, I was going to say possible award winner. And as was mentioned there, it is a dark period in history. So, you know, what should people anticipate? How will they feel when they come out of the movie?
I think they'll be, it's a haunting movie, but it's also very, there's hope in humanity. And it's kind of, it celebrates the life. It's narrated by death, which is so interesting. But you can catch all of our interviews at InTheFoxLight.com. And as always, Heather,
yes,
you can follow me at FoxLightMichael on
Twitter.
Which
I do.
Which you do.
On Twitter and Instagram and Facebook and everything else.
And all the social media stuff.
All over the place.
They're all over it.
All right. Thank you, Michael. We appreciate it. And...